simple homemade barbecue, which will be happening a lot if it's not already started. Nanzanga Jamhuri Demki and Akabisa. So this is a simple way that you can do or make your barbecue at home for your family and friends during this festive season. Take a look.
Hey everyone, welcome to the masterclass. This is, my name is Chef Rubia, and I'm a professional chef and the owner of Chad Grill Restaurant and also Chad Grill Company, which owns a range of products. Some of the products, I'm going to be using them today on the barbecue masterclass. And for today's menu, I'm going to be doing four things. So the first thing, I'm going to show you how to do like a simple, easy, gourmet style kind of a chicken wings using some, infusing some of the different flavors using the sauce. And the second recipe, I'm going to show you how to do some very nicely done gourmet burgers. And the third and fourth recipe, I'm going to be doing two types of ribs. So I'm going to do your pork ribs and I'm going to do your beef ribs. So without further ado, let's keep on with the process, yeah? So over here, I have some chicken wings. They're already cut into pieces. And for you to have your chicken wings to actually have the best result when you're grilling them on the charcoal grill or using them in the oven, huh? You need to have a very, very nice, probably a marinade or a rub. For this case, I'll be using my personal rub, which is here. It contains all the ingredients that you can actually find in a rub. So I'm going to do this, put the rub inside, and then add a little bit of some oil. There we go. And then I'm going to mix everything up. So I'm going to put on my gloves. Hygiene is important. So I'm going to wear my gloves. And in the meantime, the oven is already preheated, 180 degrees temperature for like 5 minutes. And then once your marinade is ready, you just put the chicken breast on a baking tray and cook the chicken breast for like around 20, 25 minutes. And then you'll be done, yeah? So as you can see, very simple, easy. You can see the color. I'm going to add a little bit of more to give it more kick and flavor. So the good thing with the rubs, it saves you a lot of hassle. Huh? So I'm going to take the chicken wings, and then line them on the tray. There we go. This aside. And I'm going to put this in the oven. So 180 degrees temperature, and then put it in the oven for around 20, 25 minutes. And it'll be ready, yeah? So here we go. As you can see, our oven is so hot. Yeah. And then there we go. So 25 minutes and we'll be done for the chicken breast, yeah? So on to our next recipe. I'm going to remove the gloves, put them aside. And we're going to be making some gourmet burgers. So for the gourmet burgers, you need the minced meat. You're going to need some eggs, which I have over here. You're going to need actually the marinade, which comprises of everything anything that you need to put actually in the burger. So with this, I'm going to have now the minced meat, the eggs. I'm going to have some little bit of some salt, and I'm going to have some breadcrumbs to help bind on the minced meat. Yeah. So I'm going to take my new pair of gloves, put them on. For the best for you to have the best result in terms of burger, you need to like actually mix the ground beef with fat. So you can do probably 70% of lean meat and then do like around 30% of fat for you to get that nice marbling and juicy kind of a flavor. Yeah? So I'm going to break the egg inside and then put this aside in my dustbin. I'm going to have the rub. Sprinkle on top. So this rub has also salt, so I will go less on the salt. And then put it aside. I'm going to have a little bit of some breadcrumbs as well. So for the minced meat, you have your eggs, you have your minced meat, you have your marinade that comprise everything that you can actually need for you to marinate the burger, and you have your one piece of egg. So with this, what you need to do is only mix and get the right consistency for you to actually mold up the burger. Yeah? So here we go. I'm going to mix all of this. I can actually feel the aromas of the dried herbs, of the spices. Here we go. So we need to mix this until it gives you that firm texture for you to be able to actually mold the burger. So here we are. As you can see, it's actually, the color of the meat is actually very appealing. It's red. You can see the white part, which is the marbling part of it. So the fat, that's it's included in the lean meat. Okay. So I'm going to, in a regular kitchen, normally do the measurements for this, around 150 to 200 grams. But for this, I'll just do them manually and do like around 3 burgers that we're going to be grilling, yeah? So I'm going to be doing this. This is the first one. Grab a plate for me to put inside. Yeah. So this is like our first burger. And then I'm going to do like a second one as well. Roll it up. As you can see, everything is sticking up together. Yeah? It's not crumbling, it's not doing anything. Yeah? Then you're going to like do another burger patty. There you go. We need a couple of ingredients, yeah? We need some gherkins. I'm going to have some cheese in there. We also have our burger buns ready over here. I'm going to toast this. And I'm also going to switch on this so that we can do double of that, yeah? And now once that is done, yeah? For the next ingredients for the burgers, actually, I'll need this. So this is basically my arrangement for the burger. Yeah? So what is here is actually the lettuce, which is the base after you've done your spread of mayo. And we have our tomatoes, we have our onions, we have our gherkins ready, and we have the mayo as well. Huh? So once I'll be grilling this, I'll be actually building up on the burger buns. So I'll probably toss them lightly, spread some mayo, and then now build on this, and then present some time later. Yeah? As the bread is cooking, yeah, I'm going to probably prepare for my next recipe, which will be the ribs, yeah. So there we go. So I'll do like for the beef ribs, as you can see, yeah. I'll change my gloves as well. They are very, very nicely done in terms of the cuts, as you can see. Very tender, very nice in terms of marbling, yeah. Very tender, very nice in terms of marbling, very nicely cut in terms of the size even and all that, yeah. So let me remove the bread first and then we come back to marinating this, yeah. There we go, my bread is toasting. Ah, there we go, as you can see, it's brown already. Yeah. Nicely done, so I'll put this on the side. I'll put another piece of bread. Yeah. Put this on the side. Yeah. Sprinkle a little bit of some oil inside. Let me cut this. So a little bit of some oil inside. Yeah. And I'm going to take my beef patties. Spread a little bit more. And actually get it cooking over there. And also this second one. And do the same thing. Yeah. Let me add in the heat. Yeah. So for the beef ribs, it's easy to do the marination actually. Yeah. So what you need to do is actually take the rub, cover it on top completely with the rub. As you can see, very, 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 very nice color. You can actually see the flecks of the herbs on each and every marinade. Okay, there we go. Yeah. There we go. Yeah. So I'm going to flip the burger. There we go. And reduce on the heat while it's cooking. So once you've done this, What you need to do next is actually seal this with foil and put it in your oven. Slow cook it for like 2.5 hours to 3 hours. So wrap this airtight, very airtight with a foil, aluminum foil. Put it in your oven. Cook it for around 130 to 150 degrees Celsius for 2.5 hours to 3 hours. And by then, you're going to have like very nicely done and tender ribs. So as our burgers are cooking, let's do this. And final, finish this off with the salamander. With low heat so that it cooks passion fruit, yeah? So I'll take the beef as well. For this one, I'll use this pan because I cooked beef burger with it, yeah? So I'll put on my glove. And probably, have this in the pan. Have this in the pan. As you can see, put this aside. Take my brush again. I'm just going to do like a glaze on top. So I'm going to do like a glaze of passion flavored barbecue sauce. And here we go, as you can see. So here we go, as you can see. And then what I'm going to do next, same thing. Put it under the salamander for a few minutes for it to cook, yeah? Our burgers are actually done. I'll put them on the side. I'm going to start blanching our potatoes as we are almost ready to serve. So for the potatoes, I'm going to cook them halfway first and then remove them, increase on the temperature, and then I'll crisp them up. And once that is cooking, and I'm finalizing, I'm going to build up on the burger. So for the burger, I'm going to take the burger buns that I made, spread some mayo in them, build up the lettuce, tomatoes, and onions, and the gherkins, and then now have the meat and finalize it with the cheese. So I'm going to get my mayonnaise. Let me check on the beef. See, even for the beef, where it's cooked, just from the farm. And put it at the middle. And then that much as well. And then put it at the middle. And then to get my tomatoes. Do some nice slices. Some nice slices. And actually put them at the middle. There we go. Let me check on the ribs again. So the ribs are done, they are cooked. So I'm just going to put them below the salamander because there's less heat on there, As the oil is actually getting heated up, I'll finish on the burger. And then have it on top as well. And slice a little bit more of this. And then there we go. So these are the builder for the burger. I'll have them set aside. And now I'm going to do clear ones over here so that I can actually do the final presentation of the entire meal. So the last thing that I'll actually do now is remove the wings from the oven. And I'm going to baste them on top. Same thing I did with the ribs. Just baste them on top. There we go. On the last pieces. There we go. So after this, I'll also put them back in the oven for like a minute or so. And then we're good to go, ready to serve. I'll actually put a greaseproof paper on top. Just to give it that kick and difference. So the first one, I'm going to serve it. This is for the starch. Just to give that different feel and kick. And then that's the last one over there. And then this one as well. This one over there. So our fries, let me check the progress. Yeah, coming on along well. So I want to remove them and spicing them up. And I'm going to come here, do the rub. and then do the cayenne and paprika mixed up together, and then mix it up. I'm going to do like a simple garden salad on the small ramekin I have over here, yeah, to give it that more color and break the dark color of the plate, huh? You can see, there we go. And then the last bit, here we go, here we go. Aha, so there goes our salad. And now to our main thing. No, before the main thing is always the last, yeah? So now the homemade fries, huh? So I'm going to actually put this in the respective places. You can see the spice actually on them. Here we go. And now the last bit is here. On the last bit, yeah. So I'm going to also put this on the side. And now the main thing is the ribs now, yeah. So I'm going to take this and serve it as a rack, yeah. So I'm going to have this over here, and I'm also going to have like this one right over there, yeah. So I'm going to flip this over, and I'm going to have our beef ribs as well, nicely presented in form of like a rack. Just want to hold this over here, and this one over here, and then probably cut this into half, and then have this over here, probably have the last chunk right over here, yeah, right over there, and then I'll put this back. And now I'm going to do the wings. So for the wings, let me remove them from the salamander. There we go. So I'm going to grab a spoon and actually, have them served on the platter. Because actually the sauce is giving that perfect effect, because giving that burning effect, it's like they almost burnt, but it's called charred. They're charred, not burnt. There we go, and then the last bit. There we go, and then we save this for the camera crew behind the scenes. We are going to be loving this today. So the last thing I'm going to do is the burger. So I'm going to grab one bill up of the burger. I'm going to do like a double burger, yeah? So yeah, there we go. And I'm going to take up the top as well and put it on top, yeah, and then hold it, and then there we go. So ladies and gentlemen, those are our meals for the day. So here you have your pork ribs, here you have your wings, and here you have your beef ribs, and there you have your burger, your gourmet burger. So that's it for the day. I hope you enjoyed the masterclass. I hope you learned something new, and try this at home, try it in your place of work, try it in your kitchens, and then these are the amazing results that you're going to be getting by the end of it all. So thank you guys for watching. It's been a pleasure. I've been your main chef for the day, Chef Rubia. So till next time, see you guys.
Welcome back. That food looks so good. My God. Sijui ndakuwa nikifanya nini after nimalize show hapa because... But before all of that, after all of that, because we've seen all of that, I promise to give one winner among our audience, mtu mmoja mwenye taniambia three things that Lily Balavish alileta hapa, Lily Richards alileta, and she is the founder of what she said. Yeah, na nikamwambia ametoka America, right? Hiya, so full circle with Mikali, you look beautiful as always. So Lily's products are foundation, liquid, highlighter, lashes, founder of Kenya Women Network. Nope. Mungina nasema Lily by Lavish, 5D lashes, setting powders, primer, foundation, liquid highlighter, but she didn't tell me who or what she is the founder of. So that is what I was looking for, and most of you hamkuniambia. But kuna mshindi moja kutoka Mlolongo, she's called Ruth, and your number starts at 0720 and it ends with 272. And it ends with 272. You are the winner of the Lavish by Lily makeup package. So congratulations. See you tomorrow, guys, for another maybe giveaway. We'll let you know. Mimi ni lem say it's Christmas. So as we say kwaheri, it is important that you give your mom and dad the protection that they deserve. Now E-Plus, the leading emergency evacuation ambulance service, understands that your parents' health is a priority. So get your parents' individual membership for emergency evacuation for only 2,500 Kenya shillings per year. And when you do this, you're giving them treatment and stabilization on site, and pre-existing conditions are not excluded. You're giving them access to unlimited emergency ambulance services. You need to protect what is important to you. So to do that, you need to call us today on 0700-395-395 or 0738-395-395. Time is life. That is all we had for you today. It's been an exciting show. I hope you learned a lot. I hope you had a good time. I hope you learned how to do the tree. I also learned as well. And takia siku njema, tuonane kesho. Adios.